When I say Nakumbuka, I want you to say I remember. Nakumbuka. I remember that before our ancestors were brought here in chains. That began the first civilizations in Africa. In Memphis, in Peru, in Timbuktu. We built the Great Wall of Zimbabwe. We built the pyramids. We built the Sphinx. I remember that we have a history that began before Columbus, the Pinta, the Maria, the Nina, and the Jesus. Nakumbuka? I remember that in the belly of those ships, our ancestors were chained, packed like sardines, made to lie flat on tables, on clothes, made to urinate and defecate on themselves, made to die from cholera, typhoid, sickness, made to chose suicide when they had an opportunity to die overboard. As Dr. Basil said, millions of them lay at the bottom of the Atlantic Ocean. Nakumbuka. I remember it is our duty to honor the memory of our ancestors and the hopes and dreams that those who come to life held on to. And what were those hopes and what were those dreams? Was it to see an independent Jamaica where we would be divided by party, divided by caste? No. That dream was a dream which enveloped the hope of a return to Africa and a return to our family. Understanding that the word remember does not only mean to recall, but it also means to make whole what has been dismembered. Is remembered by their students, and that teachers have the power within their hands to shape the minds of all of our citizens. Nakumbuka. I remember when we had a Garvey club very vibrant on this college campus. And part of the reason that we are here today is to see if those fires can be relit. One of the most phenomenal things that he did at the time when he was alive and speaking was to speak of our story, our history before slavery. As teachers, you should know that that is something that is lost within our educational curriculum today. I'm a teacher myself. One of the questions I ask when I speak at schools is for a student to get up and name the ships that Columbus came on. Inevitably, there's always a student who can. And one day in contemplation, I thought to myself, how silly and ridiculous are we as a race? For a people who cannot even remember the names of their ancestors, their language, where they came from in Africa. But they can remember the name of the ship that the white man came on. And our education system allows you to teach that. Marcus Garvey spoke of a concept called African redemption. Redemption means to redeem. Redeem means to restore value to. We have an education system that has taken away the value of Africa. We learn of Ebola. We learn of slavery. But we do not learn that writing and mathematics, astrology and physics started in Africa. We know the name of the first man to walk on the moon. We know the name of the first president of America. We know It does not speak of Akhenaten. It does not speak of Ernest Maxwell, Norbert Rieu, Michael Henson, Daniel Williams. You know it doesn't speak of them because you don't even know who I'm speaking about right now. Nakumbuka, I want you to remember that as teachers, you are not bound by a curriculum given to you by the very same people who enslaved your ancestors. And understand that education is not the regurgitation of things each generation is taught to memorize. Education is supposed to empower your students. As a teacher, when you are in those classrooms, do not let the curriculum be the sole thing that you focus on. Pay attention to your students in front of you. I asked my class the other day, are we still teasing the darkest person in the class? I asked them that because I remember my time in school. The unfortunate answer was yes. Why are we still doing that? We wonder why we have problems with preaching in this country. Because as teachers, we are so focused on the British curriculum we have inherited and not focused on empowering our students to embrace their African identity and to Nakumbuka. When you leave this institution, you have a great responsibility ahead of you. But you cannot teach what you yourself have not been taught. Over 10 years ago, when we launched the Garvey Club here, the first UNIA Garvey Club in the island. Now we have many schools and many colleges and universities, but I want you all to remember that we got right here at Mico. I am happy now to see that we have a Garveyism course at the present. I would like to urge Michael to go one step further and to make that course compulsory for every teacher. And this will require a serious understanding and definition of what Garveyism is. Garveyism is not merely social sciences. In fact, if you're going to have a course that only teaches you the biography of Mom, then I would call such a course history and not Garveyism. Garveyism speaks to how we can use a racial and cultural education to empower people. It means that students who pass through your hands, once you have learned Garveyism and learned to impart it, will not be teaching, will not be on the playground teaching each other about their black life. Garveyism is designed to eradicate